Hello everyone, I welcome you again in my YouTube channel Metamorphosis, and I am trying my best toiling day and night to make videos which are very helpful for you. And in that, last time I started my series with M.H. Abraham, which is supposed to be a very important and complex book to understand. So last time I told you about the concept, and that concept was a very important concept. And this time again one more important concept, that is affective fallacy. So affective fallacy we are going to discuss. Many times many questions are asked from this, and it is in M.H. Abraham. You can go through M.H. Abraham after listening to my video. So let's start what affective fallacy is and how it is important to understand this term. So I would like to tell you that the first question which may be asked, that who gave this fallacy, this term. So W.K. Wimsett and Munro C. Birdsley. So Wimsett and Birdsley in 1946. So you can see that it is a 20th century theory and quite modern theory. And this theory says actually that we commit an error while evaluating a poem, and that error is done when error we do of evaluating a poem by its effects, especially emotional effects. I will narrate or explore this afterwards. Let me first tell you that why this theory came into existence and what do they mean by emotional effect. So we will go to at first I.A. Richard, which was, you know, a new critic, and he wrote Principles of Literary Criticism in 1923. And you know that in Principles of Literary Criticism, he said there that value of a poem is judged by the psychological responses which it incites inside the human mind or a reader. Now, this is very important, that at that time, the whole theory of I.A. Richards was based on psychological impressions. Now, what they say, Wimsett and Birdsley say, no, if Richards idea is that we are going to make the value of poem by the psychological responses, there will be an error. Because think for a while, suppose you are quite disturbed by some clashes in your family and you are being given a poem. Your condition or your psychology at that time is not up to the mark, and you are going to understand that poem in the same way as your psychology is at that time. Or take another instance, suppose you are going through great headache or stomachache and you are being given a piece of literature. What psychological responses you are going to give to the poem? So whenever we give it to different people have a different psychological bent, they have different frustrations, they have different subconscious mind situations, they have different experiences they have gone through different experiences in the life. So all the psychologies differ, and this way they are under one emotionality, and that emotional effect, due to that emotional effect or impact in their mind, they are going to disclose or decode the text or the poem by the impression of that emotional effect. Now what Wimsett and Birdsley say, they say if somebody is going to read a poem according to the psychological responses his mind is giving or a reader, so what will happen? He will go entirely to the emotional effects which is in his personality or which is in his thinking. And then due to this emotional effect, there may be an error in understanding the gist or the soul of the piece of poetry. And this very error which comes there into existence due to the emotional effect is called the affective fallacy, because the emotional effect actually are making it very different from the gist or the soul of the poem. So fallacy means that error, and affective means due to the effect, certain effect, and that effect is emotional effect. Now what happened due to this, after that this came into limelight, this theory affective fallacy. So lot many people started supporting this, and some persons started criticizing it. But when we go to further, so Wimsett and Birdsley start advocating they promotes an idea that actually our affective fallacy tells another idea by this, and that is we are advocating objective criticism, because if we are not under the emotional effect, the chances of committing an error will be less, and we are going to just analyze the piece by maintaining the objectivity. Then something happens in this which is very important. As you know, that a very important postmodern theory is reader response theory, where they say that the piece or the text under analysis is totally judged by the responses of the reader. It came into 1970s, and they opposed Birdsley's theory. They said no, objective criticism or emotional effect and this affective fallacy we do not support, because it support that our responses by the readers are important when we talk about the text and when we talk about analyzing a text or valuing a text. So in a way, this is a kind of support to I.A. Richards, and this is a kind of opposition to A.C. Birdsley's theory. So dear students, this is actually affective fallacy, where you commit an error due to the emotional effect, and this was given by Birdsley and Wimsett. And what happened in regard to this, I have already explained you. I hope that you are enjoying these M.H. Abrams series with Nagendra, and you please keep liking and keep sharing, and share as much as you can, and subscribe this video channel so that all the videos can reach to you very fast. Thank you, have a nice day, and see you very soon with a new video. Thanks a lot.